Steve Bould has a groin strain, so Gus Caesar continues to deputise at number 10 while awaiting a possible suspension for his sending off in Miami last Sunday. And winger Brian Marwood, out of first team action since last April with Achilles trouble, is named among the substitutes. One of Liverpool's flank players, Ray Houghton, is now ruled out by injury, so it looks as though Steve Nicol will play on the right-hand side of midfield with Venison and Burrows at fullback. Beardsley and Rush are the front pair, so John Aldridge, scorer of 60 goals in the last two seasons for Liverpool, starts off as a substitute. A sizeable crowd basking in the Wembley sunshine as referee Alan Gunn of Sussex gets the Charity Shield match started. Liverpool in grey. Lots been said about the fact that Arsenal are trying to beat Liverpool for the third time running. But if they do, they'll become the first London team to win this Charity Shield for 27 years, would you believe? Spurs, the last side from the capital to lift this trophy in 1962. Arsenal were last here 10 years ago, 1979, when they were beaten 3-1 by Liverpool. For whom Hussein brings the ball forward, which is something I think we shall see him do quite a lot. This is Adams for Arsenal. Merson collected that well and found Rocastle. Dixon. Nice interchange. Dixon again. Oh, and he's round the back. And still Dixon. And he got carried away at the end. Can't blame him. It was a lovely run. But perhaps right at the very end of it, he could have just pulled that back to Merson rather than shooting himself. It's very easy to be critical from here, of course. But look at this combination between Dixon and Rocastle. That's clever play by Arsenal. Good understanding. He collected it very coolly indeed. Shook off the attentions of Burrows. And then look, Merson wants it, but it's side netting. Now Barnes. And now Nicol. Rush in the middle. Agonisingly wide for Steve Nicol. Well, a foot either way, it would have been either a goal or maybe a chance for Rush to just push it in, but it beat the goalkeeper and Adams saw it go wide of the post. So we had a very bright 60 seconds there. O'Leary, Nicol. Beardsley's touch in this first half has been quite magnificent. Every ball that he's played first time has gone unerringly to a colleague. This is McMahon. That was Barnes and Rocastle running back, bumping into David Burrows, and again referee Alan Gunn gives the free kick. ...25 minutes gone in the first half. Rush hit the post, lucky Lukic, it came straight back to him. Ian Rush with a header which might have Arsenal asking a question or two about the marking. Well, John Lukic could do nothing about the header, it was well away from him, but look at that. Another day it might have gone into the net off the post. Rush. Oh, Whelan. Good play by Michael Thomas in defence. He's given Rocastle the chance to start an attack. And look where Thomas is now. That's terrific play. Somebody just got in his way there. I think it might have been Alan Smith. But Michael Thomas there, 1 second back on the edge of his own area, then on the edge of the Liverpool 18-yard box. Here's McMahon. We've been playing for half an hour. It's 0-0. This is Burrows for Liverpool. Barnes. Beardsley. Oh, look at that. Barnes. Bobby Robson would have been pleased to see that move. He's here today. Champions. Venison's cross floated away from John Barnes and his marker Dixon, but Beardsley was unattended, and that's a good finish by the England player. And Barry Venison, a good ball in. Well, Dixon, the fullback, had been drawn in to mark Barnes, but there was somebody missing in the Arsenal defence. Obviously they'll work that out for themselves, but Beardsley was all alone. And it was completed by him in a tidy fashion. And it reflects the first half that Beardsley has had, because his game technically has been of a very high order. A very high order indeed. Here's Venison's ball in. Now you'll see Dixon go with Barnes here, and Beardsley, look, he's all alone, stroked in. Whelan, Beardsley, Barnes. Still Barnes has the balance to keep his feet in that sort of position where others might stumble, and in the end going for the curling shot for the far post. But he did keep upright well there, Barnes, after the initial jostling, floated it just wide. Winterburn, Smith, and now Thomas, Merson, Winterburn, and Dixon, the other fullback, did well to reach that, exceedingly well. Rocastle, and Richardson. Kevin Richardson's shot some way away. It, when that first cross went in from Winterburn, you didn't quite know where it was going, but Lee Dixon appeared from nowhere and got on the end of it. Half time then in the Charity Shield, and Liverpool, whose recent fortunes against Arsenal have not been so good, hold sway here thanks to Peter Beardsley's 32nd minute goal. Well taken, and that's the difference between the two teams as they go off on a very warm afternoon, and the Liverpool manager sees his team in front at half time, and George Graham in the other dressing room has his team talk to do with the champions, one down. No extra time or penalty shootout scheduled today. If this match was drawn in 90 minutes, then the two clubs would share the FA Charity Shield, holding it for 6 months each. And each side allowed to use any two of their nominated five substitutes. So particularly with the heat, we may well see a change or two in the second half. Well, it was 3-2 to Liverpool 25 years ago when Ronnie Moran played. So far today, it's 1-0 to Liverpool. Well played by Burrows. This is Barnes. And a typical Ian Rush run that. Absolutely Ian Rush all over. Moved away from Adams, got himself a couple of yards. The end product not perhaps as good as it could be, but John Barnes saw what was happening, and Rush does that so much. Remember those cup final goals against Everton? In fact, there were four of them altogether, I think. But Arsenal are stretched now, and they're going to have to do something about it. And they do have an opportunity here to change the way the team is shaped, because Gus Caesar is being taken off, one of the central defenders. And Brian Marwood, who hasn't played a competitive first team match since last April, will replace him. Marwood's been playing his way back to fitness through the reserves in pre-season, and he of course is an orthodox wide player, which means Arsenal will now only have the flat back four and a winger, or an extra forward if you like, up front. McMahon, Rush, that's opened it up a little bit. This is Beardsley, and Rush is going through the centre. Still Beardsley, good save. John Lukic was, 7 yards off his line as Beardsley shaped to shoot, and that positioning paid off by the Arsenal goalkeeper, as you'll see from that. Corner to Liverpool. Hussein. Oh, dear me. It's a present to Beardsley. And O'Leary has to stretch, and this is Barnes, and Rocastle, whose bad pass really put Arsenal in difficulties there in the first place, in trying to make up for his error, committed the foul. That was a case of overcompensation, really, by Rocastle, but it's given Liverpool a threatening position. John Barnes has sized up the angle here. Whelan is there with him. And Whelan pulls it back for Venison, and it hit Rocastle. And now it's McMahon, and Barnes now on the right. keeps his feet. Beardsley in the middle, so is Rush. And Lukic did well. Beardsley. And that's a corner off David O'Leary. But the goalkeeper, Beardsley, was foiled by him earlier. And there, Lukic's clearance from this cross meant that Rush couldn't make it 2-0, as he surely would have done if Lukic hadn't got an arm out. Liverpool still on top then. Funny how goalkeepers pushing the ball out like that can often make the difference as to whether it's a goal or as to where it goes in the cup final. Everton scored in the last minute when Bruce Grobbelaar could only clear the ball as far as McCall. Well, there, Lukic's touch was strong enough to divert it away from Rush. Well, Liverpool have looked a shade more sprightly in these heavy conditions than Arsenal up to now. And it could well have gone away from Arsenal, the match, but it hasn't. It's still 1-0. This is Adams. Thomas. Oh, nice dummy. Here he is again. But you have the feeling that Liverpool are, in their typical fashion, luring Arsenal forward and then looking for the quick advance. And it has happened right now with Steve Nicol. Nigel Winterburn takes the ball and saves Arsenal. And no Liverpool protest there to the referee. The fans called out for a penalty. But Winterburn takes the credit for a recovery run and shows that you can tackle from behind fairly and take the ball. That's kept Arsenal in the match, there's no question about that. And it's also their corner. O'Leary's up for it, so is Adams. Gone back to Marwood. Oh, Merson was coming in on that. Burrows. He's had a good match at left back, David Burrows. And Liverpool are working the ball precisely now. This is McMahon. There are options open to him, right and left, and through the middle. And here's Burrows. Good move. And it hit David O'Leary. What a terrific goal that would have been. And Burrows having a splendid match here. He's got competition for that left back spot from the likes of Ablett and Staunton. And he seems to be on top of his game. £500,000 signing, though, last season from West Brom. So they'll be expecting something from him. And Liverpool were expecting something earlier from Stevie Nicol, because he broke clear. Now watch Nigel Winterburn come in from behind. Most cases here, this would have been a penalty, but he gets his leg wrapped right round the ball. And he took the ball fairly, said the referee. Arsenal are going to make their second substitution. It's one tall striker for another here. Alan Smith is going off. And he'll be replaced by Niall Quinn, Republic of Ireland international, who's been frustrated by his lack of first-team opportunity in the last couple of years. Barnes has come through everybody now. They've got a two against one. Rush has gone to the right. Arsenal scampering back. Winterburn was there. And a foul by Michael Thomas on John Barnes. In by Barnes, his rush, good save, and rush again, but only as far as Winterburn. John Lukic again, extending himself effectively for Arsenal. Oh, it was swung wide beautifully to Marwood, and Hansen this time takes charge. But Liverpool just hesitating a bit defensively there when the ball came out. There's Venison. Marwood again. Here's Thomas. And Rocastle. And Marwood. Five players waiting for a cross. Quinn! Well, Arsenal have looked a more potent force since Marwood and Quinn came on. One to supply the crosses, the other one to jump for them. Beardsley's touch, here comes Rush. And he held that up nicely for Whelan. This is Barnes. Waiting for Burrows to come down the left. Oh, what a good little ball. And Rush was waiting. McMahon is there too. McMahon hoping to get on the end of a very good move. Barnes was involved on the left with Burrows. And these two have combined really well down here. In fact, I've been very impressed by Burrows' performance at left back. This is Hansen, meantime, who hasn't put a foot wrong. Back as captain too, incidentally, Hansen. Whelan had the job last season while Hansen was injured. Foul. Adams on Rush. Less than 5 minutes away from retaining the Charity Shield, which they won here. Kenny Dalglish's team beat Wimbledon a year ago. They're now leading 1-0 against Arsenal and have made the chances to have increased that lead, really. Here's Whelan. Barnes. Beardsley. One or two players tiring a bit now. It's a very humid afternoon. Here's Beardsley, who's certainly got through his share of work. You can see a trophy just a minute or so away. Here's Merson, though, trying to do something about that. Quinn is waiting for a cross, and it's coming. Beardsley, what a good little turn, and a good pass too to Rush. He wanted the return at first, but Rush saw a way through himself. Liverpool rather more comfortable winners here than 1-0 might suggest. They made the chances to have scored more. And it's the FA Charity Shield again for Liverpool, thanks to Beardsley's goal. They retain the trophy and get some small measure of revenge for what Arsenal have done to them in recent meetings. John Lukic fully extended in the second half. And George Graham's thoughts that Kenny Dalglish's team would be even more determined this season, if that's possible, fully borne out by that performance.
So Liverpool's Alan Hansen collected the first additional trophy of the season. And the manner of his team's victory in the Tenants' Charity Shield before a crowd of 63,000 would have added to the worry lines on the faces of the 19 other First Division managers. And for the captain of Sweden, Glenn Hussein, a winner's medal on his first competitive appearance for his new club.
Well, I'm quite satisfied with this game. But like I told before to the journalists, it's very easy to play together with those guys in Liverpool. They're brilliant players, everybody, so it's quite easy to fit in.
Do you think it was psychologically important for Liverpool to win?
I think it was quite important to win to prove that because they lost the last game last season and they lost it in this tournament. And I think it was quite important for the players to get the confidence again that we can beat them.
Did you see that match at the end of last season when Arsenal?
I saw it on television, yes.
I suppose you didn't think at the time that you'd end up as a Liverpool player, did you?
No. I thought I was a Manchester United player then, but...
I think everybody did.
Things changes. And I'm very satisfied to be here.
I know it's difficult, but what would you say were your particular attributes as a player? How would you describe yourself as a player?
Well, I'm a pure defender, and I think I'm quite good in the air. I think I can read the game, because I'm not too quick, so I have to be there before the others. Good size to be a defender. It's no idea to hurry with the ball, just take it easy and play it very simple.